A long time ago, a time before airplanes and cars and buses and trains.
A time before television, CD players, computers, and video games. There is a quaint little village in a green valley next to a gently flowing river.
Artists came from miles around to paint pictures of the valley with its river and village because it was so beautiful.
And the name of the village was Hamlin.
Needless to say, the good citizens of Hamlin were very concerned.
In fact, there goes one now. It's Mr. Rock. He's the town baker. Everyone loves his rolls. If they could get to him before the rats.
And there's Miss Lilyspoon. She's the town librarian. Good morning, Miss Lilyspoon.
Why, hello, dear. Have you seen the book, The Three Blind Mice? It's disappeared from the library again, and I can't find it anywhere.
Miss Lilyspoon, I found your book. Oh, well.
Look, here comes Constable Blarney. He's a policeman, and he keeps order in our little village. Hello, Constable Blarney.
Why, hello. It is a fine morning, and I'd love to stay in chat. But I need to get over and open up the office. Oh dear, I seem to have misplaced my keys. Now, let's see. I know I had them when I left home. Maybe I dropped them off the street.
Goodbye, Constable Blarney. Now I know I had them when I reached the corner.
Oh, there's Miss Finney. She runs the bank. Hello, Miss Finney.
Good morning. I'm off to the bank to deposit more money. Best place for your hard-earned cash, the bank. Very secure. Yes, sir. You can rest easy knowing that your money is safe with me. Best be off now. Busy day ahead of me. Sorting money, counting money, protecting money. A banker's job is never done.
So that's the town of Hamlin.
Wait, don't forget the children. Billy and Wendy.
Tommy and Susan.
Wait! Don't forget me. I'm the mayor of this fair city. Good morning, Mrs. Griffin. Let me see that sweet baby here. Beautiful child. You are very fortunate.
Thank you.
find my keys.
Watch and listen. peace and quiet.
And the citizens would finally leave us alone and recognize me that the great man that I am. We'll pay you 5,000 guilders to get rid of those rats.
That is the most gracious offer, but I don't like to overcharge. Bad for business, you know. My fee is only 1,000 guilders.
That's a great deal. We should take it. Take the offer. The sooner the better.
It's a deal.
Done.
Are you a man or a mouse? I say neither. I'm a rat.
It's a great to be a rat.
So I hear these guys are on the treadmill.
Yeah, it's a real rat race.
Thank you.
you, thank you, one and all. Now back to work. Back to our normal and wonderful lives.
Thank you. She's like a statue.
Sad.
Yes, I know.
Well, that's it.
That's the end of the story?
They didn't live happily ever after.
And the children stayed frozen forever?
All because the mayor didn't live up to his promise.
Oh, well, thanks for coming.
Hold on there. Just kidding. Body out of them, fool.
We did? What? Oh, yeah. Here's what really happened.
Well, the town people discovered that the mayor had gone bad on his agreement with the pipe.
You've gone bad on your agreement!
They sent him.
You did not keep your promise!
They sent him.
Shame! Shame!
As I was saying, they sent him off with the money to find the Pied Piper.
Pay the Piper! Go!
And when he found the Pied Piper, he begged him to forgive his bad behavior and take the money that was owed him.
And the Pied Piper did just that.
But as they began the return trip, the mayor and his town council found themselves singing the children's song all the way back to Hamley.
Listen, I believe I hear the mayor and his town council returning now.
And as for the rats, they were gone forever.
Or were they?